Hello everyone, this is Aline from the Experience Research Lab. Today I will show you how to run discriminant analysis in SPSS. Imagine you are serving as a researcher for a company providing telecommunication services. The company has segmented its customer base by service usage patterns, categorizing the customers into four groups. As a researcher, you share the responsibility to develop customized offers for prospective customers. The challenge is you only have demographic data. What can you do to predict group membership? Please keep your answer in mind because I'll still need you to imagine yourself playing another role as a new credit risk assessor in a commercial bank. For many years, the bank has been in difficult situations, struggling to identify the people who have low credit risk and those who have the high ones. How can you help? The answer to both questions is running discriminant analysis. A discriminant analysis builds a predictive model for mutually exclusive and collectively exhaustive group membership by measuring the relationship of a dependent categorical variable with one or more independent scale predictors. Nominal and ordinal variables are both categorical. However, only the nominal that is suitable for the dependent grouping variable in discriminant analysis. The grouping variable may have two values or more, but the codes must be integers or whole numbers. Additionally, it must have the minimum and maximum values. Mutually exclusive means that each predictor belongs to only one group. In other words, there should be no overlap. Meanwhile, collectively exhaustive means that all predictors are members of a group. None is left behind. Talking about the independent predictors, the discriminant analysis also takes a nominal variables. However, you will use the dummy instead of the original one. While running the analysis, you should check and ensure that all predictors have a multivariate normal distribution. Last but not least, within group variance covariance matrices should be equal across groups. In this video, I bring another example. Here I have a file discrim.sav. The dataset has 5 variables. The first 3 variables that use scale measures are the predictors. The 4th one, job, which is nominal, is the dependent grouping variable. The dependent variable has 3 values. 1 for customer service, 2 for mechanic, and 3 for dispatch. My objective here is to predict the group membership and identify the character that is suitable for the customer service position, mechanic, and dispatch. Is it the outdoor, social, or conservative that is more suitable for customer service position? How about the mechanic and the dispatch? To achieve my objective, I need to run a discriminant analysis. But before I do that, I will first run a descriptive analysis on the data frequencies of the 3 independent variables, outdoor, social, and conservative. Looking at the statistics table, I can see that all cases are valid. There is no missing value. The standard error of means for the 3 variables are pretty similar. Referring to the skewness, I can tell that the data has a normal distribution, except for the outdoor, which is rather left skewed. However, with the curtosis lower than 3, I can say that the outdoor also has a normal distribution. By the way, if you want to know more about descriptive statistics, especially standard error of means, skewness, and curtosis, please check the video here. Back on the descriptive statistics, I can say that I have normally distributed data, so I'm good to go with discriminant analysis. I click Analyze, Classify, and Discriminant. It is how discriminant analysis dialog box looks. Job is the grouping variable. Since it has 3 values, the minimum value is 1 and the maximum is 3. The 3 variables, outdoor, social, and conservative, are the independents or the predictors. On the statistics window, I want SPSS to display the total and group means. I also want to see the standard deviations for the independent variables. To test the equality of group means for each independent variable, I will tick univariate ANOVAs. And to test the equality of the group covariance matrices, I will also tell SPSS to display the box M. There are several matrices of coefficients for independent variables. They are the within group correlation matrix, within groups covariance matrix, separate group covariance matrix, and total covariance matrix. But here, I will tick the first option only because I want SPSS to average the separate covariance matrices for all groups before computing the correlations. I want SPSS to display Fisher's classifications and unstandardized discriminant function coefficients. The reason is that I want to see where and how they are different. On the classification window, I want SPSS to adjust the classification coefficients to the size of each group classified using a within group covariance matrix. I want SPSS to display the summary table also called the confusion matrix, to see the number of cases assigned correctly and incorrectly to the group. For case classification, I want SPSS to apply the U method, which use functions derived from all cases other than that case. For visualization, discriminant analysis has three options: combined groups, separate groups, and territorial maps. Since I have no cases with missing values in my dataset, I don't need to worry about replacing missing values with mean. The dialog box allows me to add a new variable to my active data file by saving the predicted group membership. It is a single variable. The second option is to save the discriminant scores. The last option is to save the probabilities of group membership given the discriminant scores. It is one variable for each group. Here I will go with the first and last options. It means I will have four new variables added to my active data file later. I'm not going to bootstrap the data, so I will click OK to tell SPSS to run the analysis and present the output. And here is the output comprising several tables and visuals. In the upcoming video, I will show you how to read and interpret each table and draw conclusions from there. For more insights into data, including data collection, data entry, data transformations, and data analysis, especially in SPSS, please subscribe, listen, and watch our content. It is available in text, audio, and video format. Thank you for being with me today. I'll see you next time in the other video. Cheers!